back in 2009. Steve and I were both intimately involved with its creation and development. So we're happy to be here to present the Waterfront Hub Plan and to give you an overview of the goals and objectives set out within it. So the vision for the Waterfront Hub Plan, So the vision is for a world-class transportation interchange and dynamic new downtown extension in the Central Waterfront area. The hub study area included the lands, the Waterfront Station, Granville 200, and over the rail tracks, and included the C-bus area.
Actually, maybe just before we move off this, I just want to make a comment about from a transportation perspective and looking at a transportation hub. This area basically has all modes of transportation in it, and I challenge you to find a place in the world that has all the transportation modes that are in this location, because we have air, we have rail, there's freight movement, and that's the big one that I haven't been able to, when we were doing the study, I couldn't find a location that had an active freight rail yard underneath the hub development there. And then seaplanes, helicopter, cruise ship terminals, basically everything in there that you can think of.
Land ownership of this area is quite complex. You can see by the diagram here that the track lands that we were looking at were actually owned by Vancouver Whitecaps. Long before the previous to the hub plan, it was the Vancouver Whitecaps were looking to locate a soccer stadium there. I don't know if any of you remember that. But they still own the lands, and the rails have the right to operate within those. Waterfront Station and Granville 200 are both owned by Cadillac Fairview, managed by Cadillac Fairview. And of course, the federal governments own Sinclair Center, and Vancouver Whitecaps are the owners representing the recently approved tower at 320 Granville. So the city doesn't actually own any land in this particular area. Oh, I should also mention that the port, of course, owns land in this area as well. So the city actually doesn't own any land in this area. However, we do have some rights of access, in particularly over the east end of the Waterfront Station site. We have a right of access to create a road through that parking lot that exists today. That road has been called the Cordova Connector. So the urban design transportation objectives for the plan have three main pieces. Connect the city with the waterfront, introduce a high quality new development integrated with the transit hub, and create a world-class transportation interchange. So the first one, connect the city with the waterfront. How do we do that? First thing that we looked at was extend Granville Place Road. And because we also have a goal in conjunction with the port, who were also partners in this exercise, to link Canada Place Road down to Waterfront Road in order to link the port lands also with the city. And as I mentioned just previously, we also have a goal to create the Cordova Connector. Now, you have to appreciate these diagrams that we're showing here are showing roads that are elevated at the grade heights over the railway tracks. Another objective was to try and achieve a long-standing urban design principle that the city has about creating street end views to, in order for pedestrians to be able to see the water or the mountains beyond. We certainly can achieve that with the Cordova Connector. One of the big challenges we have is how do we do that with Granville Street? So that was an idea that we thought was important in pursuing and understanding how we could achieve that. So the plan actually looks at how can we get what we call the Granville Street extension, and at what elevation it would connect with Canada Place extension. And then another road in there is a hub street. And Steve is going to talk a little bit more about the transportation needs of the area and why these series of roads and how they're configured are critical for serving the area, not only the development of the area, but also the transportation hub. Other objectives with connecting the city to the waterfront is to extend our waterfront walkway that goes around the edge of the city. So that was a key goal. And also to look at open space opportunities, particularly at those street end views, and to provide people places to look out over the water and to the mountains beyond. Beyond, you know, instead of being held back where we are today with the current little parking lot plaza, we're held back from the water because of the rail tracks. Also to look at open space linkages within the plan to help facilitate transportation movements between the different modes. The next piece of urban design objective was to introduce a high quality new development integrated with the transportation hub. And that's really to create a high density commercial and mixed use development that takes advantage of excellent transit accessibility and support increased transit riders. Extend the central business district as well as complements the activities of Gastown. The architecture of the area would be of exceptional quality, reflecting the prominence of the setting and respecting the existing heritage buildings. And a commitment to environmental sustainability in all aspects of the design and construction of the buildings. Sorry, it just looks the same. Sorry. That's the
opposite. Okay, so from a transportation perspective, there was a number of goals within this area. As we mentioned, the passenger concourse, what's there right now doesn't really respect the movement that's required in that area. So having a more grand passenger concourse where you can have all those movements happen and not feel constrained. A marine transit terminal. So right now there's the sea bus down there. In the past, we've had various forms of passenger ferries coming in and out of that area. So in the future, we could see that happening again and connecting to a lot of the islands and that's something that's destined to come at pretty much at any moment. There's been a number of tries in the past, and at some point it's going to be successful. Clear and direct and attractive links. If you have a transit hub and you have all these interconnections, you need to have the ability for big movements to happen in those areas so that you know where to wayfind and how to get to these cities. And that's what any major transportation hub in the world would have, that kind of facility. And then the other thing is looking long term. Like, don't just think about what's there now, but what's going to be coming in the future. Increased passenger rail. Right now we've got West Coast Express that comes into that area, and the other passenger rail kind of ends at the flats. But in the future, we could see that coming right into the downtown, connecting into this hub. So what does that look like? Here's some good examples of what a world-class hub would look like from other areas in the world, right? Like in Berlin and London, they have these facilities that have these connections in between, and it doesn't feel cramped. More examples of this, wide open spaces, able to make those connections. And so what do we have? It starts pretty well at the street with the heritage building, but then when you go in there, it's all cramped space. If you've ever been there when a West Coast Express train comes in, good luck in trying to connect between any of those areas. Or same with the sea bus and coming across those narrow walkways. This shouldn't be something that would happen at a world-class transportation hub. Michael mentioned earlier about like tens of thousands of people going through this area. Actually, it's hundreds of thousands. It's close to about 100,000 that enter into the hub, and then they connect to all the different modes. Today, these projections were done when we did the hub planning, and so the 2011 were projections, and today when we look at boardings in those areas, it's well over 100,000 that are connecting between these areas. So looking at the components, you can see we need to have a good connection between the marine terminal and the land terminal, and the ability to both have all the connections at the land terminal but also connect to them in a way that can act as a fare paid zone, so you don't have to go out and go through fare gates and that as you connect to all these different areas. There's also the existing heliport there, which is something that we explored, how that can continue to happen in the area. design. I'm just going to skip through some of these and go to the street network. So before I hand over, maybe I'll just talk a bit about, Anita kind of referred to some of the challenges of the street network. So right now, if we look at the existing network that surrounds the building, we have Cordova Street and Howe Street. And on Howe Street, that's the entrance to the cruise ship terminal. So if you've been down there on any of the most recent weekends, on the very busy cruise ship days, that just shuts down that area. So having that as the main entrance into this area just doesn't work. Also, the Cordova Connector, although it's really important for providing the transit circulation between Granville Street and looping back, it would only be a right-in, right-out connection because from the east, it's only fed from Water Street, right? So the Granville extension is really important to be able to have that sort of full movement connection for all the buses that would want to come in here and connect to the Hub Street. The recent downtown transit plan review, in that survey, everyone said it's really hard to connect into waterfront stations. So that was a big theme that came across in that consultation. And then Canada Place would provide the extension of the Greenway network and actually eventually connect down to Waterfront Road with the future port development there.
So just to touch a little bit more on the Granville Street extension, what we learned in the study was that one thing that we really wanted to fix was the elevated structure of Granville 200, how it's disconnected from the rest of the city, the public realm. The bridge connection that is going across Granville Street, along Granville Street, is something that it really impacts on Sinclair Center, and we'd love to see that removed. So we actually did quite a structural study to look at removing the upper level of the parking and the plaza of Granville 200 and allowing the road through. And what we learned was because that facility was originally built to support fire trucks, it's actually been built to road capacities. So that was a very interesting understanding with that the road could go through with some upgrade to the existing structure. And by removing that upper level of the parking structure, the road would come through more naturally. As we move through, I've got this going the right way now. There we go. So the next level down, the transit concourse is below, slightly, it's below grade, but it allows for connections for a Canada Line. Instead of right now, you go up and through the Waterfront Station and you'd have to go back down again. This would allow for a more level connection into the transit concourse, a below grade connection underneath the Hub Road and Canada Place extension. And we also looked at how we would support additional building structures on either side of that transit concourse. And then finally at the lower level, we were looking at expansion of transit rail systems. And we were also working quite closely with CP Rail. It did require some minor alignment of some of their rail tracks in order to achieve this, but it was all within workable means from their perspective.
And those rail tracks are there to stay. They're actually doing expansion on the two container terminals, increasing both of them by 50%, and this was a key yard for them to be able to support that that movement.
So I'm just going to do a little section through. So we see here Waterfront Station on the right. And as you come through Waterfront Station, you're dropping down to a new transit concourse level, one that is connecting below grade, but it also allows a connection at the Hub Street level, which is also important for where the buses will come into this facility. Then we move through the potential development area, those other buildings, and then eventually out to the marine terminal, always with an opportunity of taking a choice, either making a connection below grade or coming up at various points to making that connection at grade. And so here are some illustrative concepts about how the massing of this area would unfold. And you can see on the right a sketch of the concourse itself opening up and exposing the north side of Waterfront Station, actually, you know, enhancing it, we believe. And then the lower sketch at the bottom showing how Bramble Street would actually come through and opening up the westerly edge of Waterfront Station and exposing that elevation and the removal of the elevated bridge along Sinclair Center. So some of our challenges to finish are the impact on the freight rail yards, development funding, Bramble Street, achieving the Bramble Street extension, and managing and dealing with dangerous goods. Thank you.